Are you tired of transporting your heavy machine around with the wire? What? Shit, the cable again. I don't want more cables. No problem, I have this cable extension here. Should be easy to bring electricity to here. We just need to get some cable from here. I hate cables, Very good, my friends. In today's video, we are going to review the Brill GSP18V21 from Bosch. Let's see what came in the box. I bought it myself in Leroy Merlin. There was an offer and it only cost 170 euros. The regular price is like 200 euros. So let's see what we get in the box. We get two 18 volts battery, lithium batteries, 3 amperes hour, okay, the drill and the charger. And also we have the instructions. I have the ticket here and some 25 pieces of a screwdriver. Okay, this is the charger. We will see it working later. The additional extra battery we have here and the drill itself. The drill has a small light when we are working in a shadow place. Okay, we have 3 operating modes: screwdriver, drill, and impact drill. Then we have 20 torque modes. Okay, 20 is the strongest mode and 1 is the lowest. We have 2 gear speed. The first one, low speed range for working with large drilling diameter or for screw driving, and second gear, high speed range for working with a small drilling diameter. Rotation is selected here. You press here to go left, okay, and you press the other side inside to go right, okay. And if you want to turn off the drill, you put it in the middle position, okay. Now I cannot trigger the drill. The battery has a capacity indicator, okay, has 3 LEDs indicator. It's removed by pressing here and it's very simple to put back in position. To start charging the battery, we just need to put the battery in this position and it's ready to charge. The LED indicator in the battery will blink until the battery is fully charged. When it's fully charged, light not blinking more, that means that the battery is fully charged. So I'm going to disconnect, and when the light turns off, I can remove the battery. Here is a 25 pieces screwdriver that I have. To put the piece, we slide inside, hold here, doing like this, the fast mode, you can do like this. And it's ready to be used. This piece here has been annoying me for some time. Look, it doesn't allow me to open it easily, so I'm going to move it a little bit. For this type of job, I'm using speed 1 and screwdriver function. And now, yes. Perfect. And to remove the tool, we just need to do like this and it's out. As easy as that. Okay, next job, drilling a hole in that metal box with this tool. Okay, let's insert there, rotate. Good. We are going to select drilling and speed 2, fast. We are ready to drill. Yes, and torque 20. Solid steel. The drill weighs 1.4 kilograms. It's lighter than the normal drills. I find this weight very comfortable.
I think for steel is better, speed 1.
I can do holes in most of the regular materials, It takes more time than the standard drill because I think the speed is slower and it's powerful, but to be a portable drill, it is much better one. I was looking for a convenient tool and this is very convenient. And with a standard drill you cannot put screws. Now let's test the impact drilling. I'm going to use number 6. Speed 2. Torque 13, 20. Okay, let's see. 55 newtons per meter of hard torque delivers the performance necessary for the basic drilling and screw driving. It can take drill bits from 1.5 to 13 millimeters. The speed on the first year is 480 RPM and in the second year 1800. This hole here took me 24 seconds. I think all the time I was working on hard concrete. Number 6, let's see. Nice. Okay, now I'm going to make a hole here. I'm going to start in drill mode because I don't want to break this piece here. Changing to drill, impact, drill. Another good thing about this drill is that it can fit in places where other standard drills cannot fit. If you have questions, let me know in the comments. I hope this video has been useful for you. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, press the like button. Thank you for watching and see you in next video.